Assalamu alaikum, everybody.
Walaikum assalam, Professor SockPuppet.
Welcome to today's show. We'll be learning about getting married as young Canadian Muslims in today's world.
Yay!
I'm so excited!
Well, Ruby, you should be, because today we'll have a guest speaker, a field trip, and a sing-along!
Yay!
This is gonna be the best class ever.
Let's get started and bring out our first guest.
I hope he's McDreamy.
He's a retired general from Puppetstan who was dishonorably discharged. You may know him in our local community as the first and only president to be impeached for election fraud and for transforming the sister's section into the sister's corner.
Well, you know, that's neither here nor there, but I'll be running for re-election again.
Well, anyways, please welcome Angry Uncle.
Yay!
The reason why I invited him today is because he has a lot of experience in the topic of marriage. In fact, he was just recently married for the third time. Not sure how your exes feel about that.
No. We're all still married. Very happily married.
Angry Uncle, can I ask you a question? How did you meet her?
I was at an upscale establishment that you all may know, Cocody's, with my second wife celebrating our first year anniversary, and wife number three happened to be the backup belly dancer there. I asked for her number, and bada-bing, bada-boom.
Damn, homie.
Professor SockPuppet, how would we know when we're in love?
Well, Ruby, I'm glad you asked that question. You know that feeling in your heart when you find a great deal at Kmart? That's what love feels like.
You know that feeling that you get when he pulls up in his Corvette? That's what love feels like. You know that feeling that you feel when you see Zola in her heels? That's what love feels like.
You know that tingle in your pants when you see her belly dance? That's what love feels like.
Love is more than a tingle in your pants. It's a feeling in your heart. More than lost or cheap notions of romance. It's a feeling in your heart.
Yay! Yay!
Well, kids, we just talked about how it feels to fall in love. But that's not the hard part. The hard part is finding somebody.
Do that. I need to find me a man. Where the brothers at? Are they hiding or something?
Well, I'll tell you where the brothers are at. You can have your family look for you. You can try online dating. I know we'll have a few friends who met their significant other through that. You can also join your local Muslim community organization. Go to Muslim conferences. I know people have met through Mac or MSA.
Well, let's not forget Coco D's there. Thursday nights from 9 to 12.
My brother told me the best place to meet chicks is at hot yoga.
Okay, everybody, settle down. There's still one more place to find love that we haven't talked about yet. Back home.
Puppetstan!
That's right, Ruby. In fact, here's an example of what they're doing back home to find love.
My name is Gandhi Nalivala Bhatt. I am educate from the Gujjar Khan Garment Institute of the Agriculture. I am looking for the romantic wife from the weight of 160 pound to 200 pound. I am looking for somebody who can help me milk my water buffalo. I voted for the Nawaz Sharif, but in my heart, I supported Imran Khan. Please climb the cherry picker of my heart and fall into my destiny by emailing me at balletere@penduhookup.com.
Aw, hell nah.
I don't know. I thought that was pretty good. It's times like this I wish I was a woman.
Well, what do you guys think we should look for when we're looking for a husband or a wife?
He has to make me melt with just one look. He has to respect my mind, my body, and my soul. Someone whose eyes I can get lost in. He has to love kittens and puppies and hamsters and gerbils and...
Child, please. It's simple. He's got to be a lawyer, doctor, or engineer. Got to know what he wants. and he best have a 4, 6, or 8 pack. She better be a 10.
Someone who's giving, soft-hearted, charitable, someone who can make me feel safe, and someone who can hold me. Yeah, no, I'm just kidding. As long as she's a wild freak in the kitchen.
Well, kids, those aren't quite the answers I was expecting. And what we should be looking for in a good Muslim spouse is someone who is righteous, pious, and a good character. It is important that he or she is good to their family and keeps good company.
Speaking of what to look for, here is someone who is currently looking for a wife. Everybody out there, please welcome Faraz!
Hey, assalamu alaikum everyone, how are you? So, just like the professor mentioned here, I'm currently looking for someone who I can spend the rest of my life with.
How is the search going so far?
It's going awesome. It's going okay. It'll get better. It'll be good.
Huh.
Well, when I get married, I want to travel the world with my husband. Do you like traveling?
I like traveling, but the thing is that I got a lot of student loans to pay off.
Well, what do you drive? Because you gots to have a nice car.
I drive a Chevy.
Do you even lift, bro?
Well, the problem is that I have fibromyalgia, so it's a disease where if I do any physical activity, I can't really...
Well, this guy sounds like a real winner.
Why don't you just man up? Dude, just pack it in. You're done.
Kids, settle down. Cars, money, status, all these things have little to do with finding the right person to share your life with. I know when I met my wife at the biannual Sloth Beaters convention, she was no Miss Piggy, but she made me feel whole.
Yeah, you know what? You're right, Professor. I'm still a great guy. I mean, I don't have everything I want right now, but I'm working towards it. I just need to find somebody who can see my potential and imagine my future with me. Thanks, Professor. I'm gonna go home and...
No. Let's get something straight here. You came in here a loser, and you're gonna leave a loser.
Well, if anyone out there is interested in a lifetime of happiness with this great, great guy, propose to him by texting I do to the number on the screen. Remember, folks out there, it's a real number. As always, Faraz, we appreciate you coming to the show. We'll see you next week when we discuss, what's the topic again next week, Jim? What? Depression? We'll see you when we talk about depression next week.
Bye, Faraz!
Get out.
So, let me get this right. First comes love, then comes marriage, then comes baby in a baby carriage. Wait, where did the baby come from?
Essentially, as far as I understand, the process comes down to the frictional interaction between two entities.
Wow, that's so cool!
Kid, you're onto something.
No, it's not about friction. I'll explain everything correctly in the science lab!
Yay!
Well, kids, the whole process starts when two people are in love, and in turn, they... out there, thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time. Yay! Oh, hey, Faraz, how are the texts coming?
Well, I got two I do's, one hell no, and one meet me at the end of the red carpet, so I hope that pans out.
Hey, that's great. Hey, Moscow's audience, keep the texts coming, and we'll see you next time. Yay! You say yay.
Yeah!
Yay!